what I want to do now is we want to set up our template pages. Now remember, the template pages are going to be sort of like our index.php. We want the user to go in and be able to generate that content on their own. Our front page.php, that's a custom page. So any other pages that you want to do. So let's go in and set up a template page, and then we'll go back and set up another custom page. So the first one is that full width page here. So let's come in and let's go in and right click and say new file. And whenever you're creating a custom, none of my tutorials are scripted, so you know, if I make mistakes, excuse me. But what this is our template page, and whenever you're creating a template page, you always use page. Anytime, this is how you create your own sort of pages, or at least allow the user to create those. And if it's a template page, you use an underscore. Kind of talked about that in class, so I won't kind of keep going on about that. And this is going to be our full width. So let's just say full width. .php. Well, let's hit enter. So we got our full width PHP file. So that is great. This is hooked up. So let's go in and do this. So let's come in and say PHP. Now get underscore header. Okay, and let's just close that PHP. And you can copy this. And give me a couple lines here, and let's just change that to footer. Okay, that's good. Now, what I want to do now is I want to go in to my prototype folder, and you notice I have that full width. We don't need the header, we just need the main content div. So let's go in and copy this. Command C and come back to our actual theme folder and paste that in. Now you do want to get rid of all the lorem ipsum, so that is going bye-bye. And remember, the main heading, you don't want this. We don't want that to say main heading at all. We want to go in and tell it, hey, go ahead and get whatever the title that the user put there, and that's called an echo. So we'll say PHP. Alright. And we're gonna say we want you to echo, and what that means is whatever the user puts, I want you to copy that and place it on the site. So I'm gonna say echo get underscore the underscore title. And that fixes that. Great. Now in here, what you want to do is you want to take that WordPress loop that we created and put it inside of here. So on my index.php, let's just go in and grab this here. That's what we want. Let's hit copy and let's just paste it in there. Okay, and that is it. But the issue here is, let me hit save and go to my dashboard. Why do I keep doing that? Localhost customs. Go to my dashboard, and if we go to our pages, let's just go to all pages, and let's just say we wanted this page to be the my work page. Let's click on my work or any page that you have, and usually there's a spot down here under page attributes that allow you to go in and set that template. We don't have it, so we do need to write something in here to make sure that it works, so that we have this. So let's go back to brackets, and inside of my PHP here, I'll just leave that alone. I need to write in a comment. So to write a comment, let's do a slash and an asterisk. And if you want, you can come back and say asterisk. backslash. And we need to give this a template name. So we need to say template name, and this is my full width template. And if I hit save, let's go back to our page, refresh. Bam, there we go. Here we go. And let's just go in and say full width template. And I'm just going. Just writing something. Let's say update. Let's see if we can view this page. Haha. You see that my content is being added to my page. So that's how you can set up a template full width page. Very, very cool. So we are done with that video.